A very good morning, kids. In today's class, we'll be talking about chemical reactions and how to write the chemical equations. Now, when we talk about a chemical reaction, you require the reagents to start off a reaction. And these reagents are known as the reactants. The chemicals that you use in the beginning of a reaction are called as the reactants, and they are always to be written on the left hand side. Whereas, as the reaction begins, new products are formed, new substances are formed, and what is now formed is called as the products, which are always to be written on the right hand side. So, your reactants will always be on the left hand side, what you are starting off the reaction with, and what is new and is formed in the process of the reaction is called as the products, which are always to be written on the right hand side. I'll take a simple equation where magnesium metal is reacting with oxygen gas to form magnesium oxide. Now, if you just write it the way I have, then in that case it is a word equation where you are just mentioning the reactants and the products formed with their names. But in case you want the reaction to be a chemical equation, then this is not how you go about it. You will need to change the reactants and the products into their chemical formula, which means for magnesium, you need to write it as magnesium. Oxygen is a gas and it is always diatomic in nature. If it is diatomic in nature, it means that you need to mention it as O2, and it leads to the product formation, which is magnesium oxide. Magnesium having a valency of 2, oxygen also having a valency of 2. Interchanging the valencies, you end up with Mg2O2, whereas the 2s get cancelled as a common factor. So your formula for magnesium oxide becomes NgO. Writing the reaction in this format is known as your skeletal equation. First one is called as the word equation. The second is known as the skeletal equation. Now, you can make your equation a little more informative. How do we go about it? For all substances which are solids, you can mention a small s in parenthesis for the solid form of the reagent. For all substances which are gaseous, you can mention a small g in parenthesis to refer that this substance is a gas. And my magnesium oxide is also a solid, so I am mentioning a S after it. Mentioning a small triangle on the arrow refers to heat. So either you write heat or you mention a small triangle, showing that to start off the reaction, you require heat in this process. Still, the reaction is not complete. The reaction is not complete because both the sides, the element number should be same. You have one magnesium here, one here. So magnesium is balanced. Whereas oxygen, you have two atoms here and there's only one oxygen on this side. Hence, your law of conservation of mass is invalid. For any process, any chemical reaction, the total mass of the reactants should be equal to the total mass of the products is the law of conservation of mass as done in class 9 by each one of you. In this case, when you add up the masses on the reactant side, you will add up the mass of one magnesium and two oxygen atoms. Whereas on the product side, you have just one magnesium and one oxygen. So the masses will not be same on both the sides. Therefore, you require the balancing of equation to satisfy the law of conservation of mass. Now, to balance a chemical equation, you cannot put the numbers anywhere and everywhere that you please. The numbers are always to be mentioned before the formula. Means, you can put a 2 here, but you cannot enter a 2 into the formula or after the formula. Since I require 2 oxygen atoms, I would write a 2 here. Now, once I put a 2 here, this makes oxygen twice, but magnesium also twice. Do likhne se magnesium or oxygen dono double ho gaya. But your requirement is reactants mein magnesium to ek hi tha, oxygen do the. Products mein your magnesium and oxygen dono do do. So to rebalance it up, oxygen is satisfied. You have two oxygens here, two oxygen idhar bhi hai. Lekin twice karne se magnesium bhi twice ho gaya hai. So you require to put a magnesium twice on the reactant side also. Hence, this is called as your balanced chemical equation. Is your final step while writing a chemical reaction. Also in some cases, you mention the final heat of the process. This heat is only to start off the reaction. At the end of the reaction, what is the net heat? Because for any process, you will require heat to break the original identities and form new identities leads to release of energy. So the net total of the energy also can be mentioned in your chemical equation. So as I said, for a solid, you can write a small s. For a liquid, you can write a small l. For a gas, you can mention a gas. Now these things are true for the reactants as well as for the products, which is on the right hand side as well as on the left hand side. But if you have a gaseous and it is a product, it should be a product which is a gas, you can mention an arrow upwards after its formula. Whereas if you have a solid formed, that is in case of a precipitate is an insoluble solid, means in a liquid medium you have something solid formed, then in that case for a precipitate, if it is a product, an insoluble product can be mentioned with an arrow downwards. Lastly, if you have a medium of water, you have a solution in water, in that case you use the notation as an AQ in parenthesis. All this information is to make your equation more informative. With this, we now know that how to write a chemical equation for a given chemical reaction. I'll be taking one more example to make it a little more clearer. My second example is with calcium carbonate. My reactant is calcium carbonate, which transforms into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now, we'll start with the word equation first. The word equation would be calcium carbonate gives calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. Just mentioning it in your language, that is your word equation, where you're just writing the spellings of the reagents used. Now, if you want it to change into an equation, you require a method where you will transform your reactants and products into chemical formula. Calcium carbonate ka formula likhte hai. Calcium valency 2, carbonate also valency 2. After interchanging, you end up in calcium carbonate, the 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Calcium oxide ka formula likhte hai. Calcium valency 2, oxygen also valency 2. Interchanging the 2, you get Ca2O2, but cancelling the common factor, you end up in calcium oxide. Carbon dioxide, carbon the valency is 4, oxygen the valency is 2, interchanging the 2, you end up into C2O4, cancelling it out, you get the simplest formula as CO2, which you already know. So you add up CO2 to it and that becomes your chemical reaction in the skeletal form. Now I would like to make this equation a little more informative. To make it little more informative, calcium carbonate is the solid that I had used. Calcium oxide is another solid which is formed. Carbon dioxide is the gas which is liberated. You may write it like this, or you can also write it like an arrow upwards to specify that it is a gaseous product. This reaction requires heat in the process, and this is the triangle that I am mentioning, which is for the heat required in the process. such a reaction in which heat is absorbed in the reaction. Therefore, there's another way of writing the same thing. Calcium carbonate solid plus heat, because you're going to give it heat, it is the requirement of the reaction. So we write it on the reactant side because it is required. Leads to calcium oxide solid and your carbon dioxide gas is formed. This particular reaction, where you are specifying the heat conditions also, such a reaction which absorbs heat is termed as endothermic. So in this case, you have your word equation, then you have your skeletal equation. This is a much more informative equation with the heat specified in the process. Now, coming to the balancing part. Have a closer look at the equation. Calcium 1 on both the sides. Oxygen 3 times, once and 2 more. Total is again 3. Oxygen dono jagahon pe 3 hai. Carbon, 1 carbon and carbon 1. So your calcium is once, oxygen is 3 times and carbon is also once. So your equation remains balanced. Just a quick recall. When you want to balance the equation, my suggestion would be try to balance those elements first which are more in number. Which means for this particular equation, you should balance oxygen first. Oxygen are 3 in number here, you have 1 here and 2 here, so it is already balanced. So your calcium carbonate on heating gives you calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. This reaction is an endothermic reaction. So we've concluded today, what do you mean by a word equation? After that, you have a skeletal equation. When you substitute the solid, liquid, gases and the heat in the reaction, it is said to be more informative. And when you balance the atoms all together, it is said to be a balanced chemical equation, is what we have ended up in. So you have a balanced chemical equation done. Thank you. With this, I close my class. My next class would be on the types of decomposition reactions and what do you mean by a combination reaction. See you then. Bye. Don't forget to like the video in case you like it. Thanks again.